Yahweh, Alpha and Omega. Oh yes, you are Yahweh, you are Yahweh, you are Yahweh, yeah, you are Yahweh, oh yes, you are Yahweh, Alpha and Omega, you are Yahweh. You are Yahweh, Alpha and Omega. You are Yahweh, you are Yahweh, yeah, you are Yahweh. Yes, Lord, you are Yahweh, yeah, you are Yahweh, you are Yahweh. Alpha and Omega, you are Yahweh. Alpha and Omega, you are Yahweh. You are Yahweh. Alpha and Omega, you are Yahweh. You are Yahweh. Alpha and Omega, you are Yahweh, you are Yahweh, Alpha and Omega. Oh, you are Yahweh, Alpha and Omega. Oh, you are Yahweh, Alpha and Omega. You are Yahweh, Alpha and Omega. Oh yes, you are glorious, so glorious in your way. You are mighty, so mighty in your way. Yahweh, Yahweh. Yahweh, you are glorious, so glorious in your ways. You are wonderful, you are wonderful, so wonderful in your ways. You are mighty, Lord, you are mighty, so mighty in your ways.
Beautiful,
so beautiful in your ways. You are faithful, Lord. You are faithful. So faithful in your ways.
Come on, let's lift our hands to the King of Kings this morning. Tell him that he is beautiful. Tell him that he's faithful. Tell him he's awesome. Tell him he's mighty. He's a mighty God. Father, we worship you this morning. Daddy, we thank you. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be exalted. You are worthy to be praised. You are worthy to be praised. My Redeemer. You are worthy to be praised. The toddlers, even the adults, we are going to be praying for them. We are going to be praying that the plan of the devil in this period that we have will not come to pass in the name of Jesus. Let's first thank the Lord God Almighty for our children. Let's give him all the praise.
We give all the praise,
Father, we thank you. Thank you for our children.
Name in the name of
your neighbor's children, every child you know, thank God for their lives.
Father,
we are still waiting on the Lord for the fruit of the womb. Thank God for the children that he's going to give unto you. Father, we thank you. Daddy, we give you all the praise, we give you all the glory. Thank you, Father. We are grateful. Open your mouth and thank God for that child. Even if they are not behaving as you want, thank God for that child. Thank him. Father, we bless your name. In the name of Jesus. We are grateful, O Lord. Thank you. Father, we bless your name. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Let's ask the Lord God Almighty for the salvation of the souls of our children. No matter how young they are not too young to know about Jesus. We as parents are the ones to tell them about Jesus. As no matter how young they are, we need to start telling them about Jesus. Let's ask the Lord God Almighty that this morning I pray for the salvation of my children. Father, let them know you in the name of Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray for the salvation of my children. Let them know you. Let them know who you are in the name of Jesus. Ask the Lord God Almighty to begin to go into the hearts of your children that they will know Christ in the name of Jesus. That is the best asset you can give your children as a parent, the knowledge of Christ in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord God Almighty, let my children know you. Let my children know you. Let them grow to serve you. In the name of Jesus, let your knowledge be in their heart. Let them want to serve the God of their fathers and their mother. In the name of Jesus. Father, Lord God Almighty, let my children know you. Let them cast after you. In the name of Jesus. That is the greatest foundation you can give unto your children. In the name of Jesus. Father, let my child know you. Let my boy know you. Let my girls know you. In the name of Jesus. Father, let my children cast after you. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let's tell the Lord God Almighty that the purpose of which they were created shall be fulfilled in their life. The devil will not truncate their destiny. In the mighty name of Jesus. Ask the Lord God Almighty, Father, let the purpose of which they have been created, the purpose of which they are on earth, let it be fulfilled. And let the devil have no part interrogating their destiny in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, they shall fulfill destiny. My children shall fulfill destiny in the mighty name of Jesus. They shall fulfill that which they have been created for. They shall be great in the land that they have been created in the mighty name of Jesus. My children shall be great. They shall be great. They shall be great. They shall be great. They shall be great. In the mighty name of Jesus. My children shall be great. They shall fulfill destiny. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Let's ask the Lord God Almighty. Any power from the pit of hell that is planning to deceive them into the world, they shall fail over them. In the mighty name of Jesus, as the Lord of God Almighty this morning, they shall not be derailed from the path of righteousness. In the mighty name of Jesus, they shall not be deceived. In the mighty name of Jesus, they shall not be derailed. In the mighty name of Jesus, let's ask the Lord God Almighty that everywhere our children will be, the hands of the Lord will be mighty upon them. In the mighty name of Jesus, wherever they are, whenever they are out, in the name of Jesus, the hand of the Lord will be mighty upon them. In the mighty name of Jesus, no evil shall befall any of our children. In the mighty name of Jesus, no disease shall be upon any of our children. In the mighty name of Jesus, the sicknesses and diseases that affect children from whatever age they may be shall not be upon them. In the mighty name of Jesus, the hand of the Lord will be mighty upon them. In the mighty name of Jesus, let's pray for the friends of our children, that in the mighty name of Jesus, our children shall move with godly children. In the mighty name of Jesus, there shall be positive influence among their peers, among their friends. In the mighty name of Jesus, our children shall be good examples. In the mighty name of Jesus, our children shall be good examples in the society. In the mighty name of Jesus, there shall be positive influence for any other children around them. In the mighty name of Jesus, they shall not be derailed by peer pressures. In the mighty name of Jesus, they shall not be derailed by peer pressures. In the mighty name of Jesus, our children shall be the ones that will be preaching Christ to their friends. In the mighty name of Jesus, they shall excel in everything they do. In the mighty name of Jesus, when our words are to be won, our children shall be the ones to win them. In the mighty name of Jesus, when scholarships will be given, our children are the ones that will be given. In the mighty name of Jesus, the spirit of excellence will rest upon them. In the mighty name of Jesus, the spirit of excellence will rest upon our children. In the mighty name of Jesus, the grace for success we rest upon our children. In the mighty name of Jesus, the power from on high we rest upon our children. In the mighty name of Jesus, our children will be untouchable for the devil. Our children will be untouchable by the demons. In the mighty name of Jesus, let's pray that the Lord God Almighty will direct the steps of our teenagers in choosing their careers, in choosing their life partners for the youth, in the mighty name of Jesus. That the Lord God Almighty will direct the steps of our teenagers in choosing the proper career, in the name of Jesus. And we help our youth in choosing their life partners, in choosing the jobs they will do, the jobs that will make them still serve God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's ask the Lord God Almighty to be the general commander in the life of our children, in the mighty name of Jesus. Let's cover all our children with the blood of Jesus, that the Lord God Almighty will be with them, that the hand of the Lord God Almighty will be mighty upon them, that the Lord God Almighty will protect them, that we will not have any reason as parents to weep over our children, in the mighty name of Jesus. As the Lord God Almighty, my children will bring me joy, in the name of Jesus. My children will bring me joy. They shall not be children of sorrow. In the mighty name of Jesus. Let's bring our prayers to a close. Father, we thank you. Daddy, we bless your name. We thank you because all the prayers we have prayed this morning shall receive answers. In the name of Jesus. Blessed be your name, Almighty Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. Father in heaven, we thank you for this morning. We bless your name. We adore you. We thank you for the gift of life. We thank you for the health you have given unto us. We thank you for making us to see the last Sunday in the month of May. Glory be to your name, O Lord, in Jesus' name. Thank you for the service of this morning. We pray, O Lord God Almighty, that you take over the service for yourself and for your glory in the name of Jesus. We therefore cover the prayers we have prayed this morning with the blood of Jesus. We pray, O Lord God Almighty, that we shall receive answers to them in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray and we cover ourselves with the blood of Jesus. No power from the pit of hell will prosper in this environment this morning in Jesus' name. O Lord God Almighty, our children shall be mighty and great in the land that you have brought them in the mighty name of Jesus. They shall be children of joy, and they shall not cause us sorrow in the name of Jesus. Nor disease shall fall upon them in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, your hands will be mighty upon our children in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, they shall excel in this land and in their lands wherever they are in the name of Jesus. Your hands will be mighty upon them in the name of Jesus. You will direct their steps, you will direct their thoughts, you will direct their fears in the name of Jesus. They shall not fall into peer pressures in the name of Jesus. They shall serve you, Lord. They shall talk about you to their friends in the mighty name of Jesus. And at the end of the day, their mouths will be filled with thanksgiving in the name of Jesus. Be thou exalted, Almighty Father. In Jesus' name, we have prayed. Amen. 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 Good morning, good morning, good morning. Let somebody shout hallelujah. So this morning, we are going to sing our hymn, Rock of Ages Cleft For Me. But before we do that, thank you for joining us this morning for Church Without Borders. And we thank God that the society is gradually opening to businesses. And we need to, you know, still be cautious. And the Lord will help us in Jesus' name. Like I said last week, please wear masks when you are going out. Especially when you will not be able to social distance, wear your mask. Like I said also, masks are available. Just give me a call, tell me the size you want, tell me the quantity you want, and they'll be made for you free of charge. Make sure you wash your hands. You can get hand sanitizers. If you can't wash your hands, sanitize your hands as much as you can. If you are sick, stay home. Especially for the kids, keep them at home as much as you can. Because, you know, they love to touch everything and, you know, experiment by touching. So the Lord will be with us in Jesus' name. And the hands of the Lord will not leave us alone in the mighty name of Jesus. So let's stand to our feet this morning as we sing our hymn, Rock of Ages Cleft For Me.
Rock of Ages Cleft For Me. Let me hide myself in thee. Let our water and the blood from thy river side which flowed be of sin the double cure. Save me from its guilt and power. Nor the labor of my hands can fulfill thy Lord's demands. Could my zeal no respite know? Would my tears forever flow? All for sin was on thy race. Thou must save and saved by grace. Nothing in my hands I bring, simply to thy cross I cling. Naked come to thee for dress, helpless look to thee for grace. Fall I to the fountain fly. Wash me, Savior, I die. While I draw this fleeting breath, when my eyes shall close in death, when I swoon towards unknown, see the only
Kept us thus far, the one who have left us, who have not left us alone, the one who have not left us to the dictates of our enemies, the one who have not allowed our enemies to wrongfully rejoice over us. Father, we just want to say thank you, Lord, this morning. Father, we just want to say we love you, we love you, we love you. We declare our everlasting love for you this morning. We thank you for bringing us to the last Sunday in the month of May 2020. We thank you for bringing us to the last day in the month of May 2020. Lord, not by power nor by might, but by your grace we are alive today. Lord God Almighty, we thank you for everything you have done. We thank you for all things you have perfected in our lives. Oh Lord God Almighty, we thank you because you are the good Father. We thank you for you are the everlasting Father. We thank you because you are the righteous Father. We thank you because you are the loving Father. We thank you for because you are the faithful Father. We thank you, Lord, because you are the blessed Father. Lord, we worship your holy name this morning. We thank you for bringing us again to your vineyard. We thank you for bringing us into your presence. We thank you because you are always ready to present present to those who are presently present in your presence. Lord God Almighty, we thank you. We give all the glory because it is written that in the presence of God there is fullness of joy, and at your right hand there are pleasures forevermore. And the pleasure of God is the solution to the pressures of man. Father God Almighty, we thank you. We thank you for your ever abiding presence. You said, Bible says, let us come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may receive, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. Oh Father, we thank you. You are just good. You are good. You are good. For Father, you are good, and your mercy endureth forever. Hallelujah to your name in the highest. May your name be praised this morning. And as we continue, Holy Spirit, continue with us. Bless us mightily today. Let us see ourselves in the light of your word. And let your word reprove. Let your word correct. Let your word convince. Oh God, let your word encourage. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father God Almighty, in the name of Jesus, we pray this morning that Lord, if you come, even at this time, count us worthy in the name of Jesus. May we not miss the rapture. May we not miss the appearing of the Son of God, the only begotten Son of God who died for us on the cross of Calvary. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for we pray in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen. One more time, you are welcome to the church of God, and the Lord bless you in the name of Jesus. You know, I was a bit surprised when my wife started praying for the children, because I have written in my to-do that we are going to be praying for children, and I didn't show it to her. So we are being led by the Spirit of God. I want us to pray, especially against this sickness. They call it children COVID, but our children have COVID. This COVID-19. It's not like this COVID-19. It's more deadly, or can I say, or deadlier? It's deadlier than COVID-19. So, we are going to be praying this morning quickly against multisystem inflammatory syndrome. You can see the name, multisystem inflammatory syndrome, MISC. They call it multisystem inflammatory syndrome in children. I want us to pray against it. Thank God that she had laid the foundation for us. I want to tell us the name so that we will pray against it. Amen. multi-system inflammatory syndrome. We are going to be praying this morning, brethren, and say, Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray against multi-system inflammatory syndrome in children. The Lord God Almighty, let that devil carry his load now, in the name of Jesus, that all our children are secured and protected. They are covered by the blood of Jesus. Children under our watch, children under our care, shall not be victims of multi-system inflammatory syndrome. This syndrome is not only affecting the lungs, it's affecting the kidney, the liver, the heart, everything together. That's why it is called multi-system inflammatory syndrome. Let's pray this morning in the name of Jesus that Lord, we come against these agents of darkness called multi-system inflammatory syndrome. We come against it in the name of Jesus. We come against it in the name of Jesus. All over the world, in the name of Jesus, we come against multi-system inflammatory syndrome in the name of Jesus. Father God Almighty, we command it now. Pack your load and go back to the devil in the name of Jesus. Our children are not your candidates. All over the world, in the name of Jesus. All over the continents, pack your load and go. Even a promise that I know, I've already had one case in this Canada. Let's pray. In the name of Jesus, we come against this sickness. We come against this sickness. In the name of Jesus, multi-system inflammatory syndrome. Pack your load and go back to the devil. Pack your load and go back to the devil. Go back to where you came from. We reject you. We reject you. We reject you. We evict you in our communities. We evict you from our nations. In the name of Jesus, we come against you this morning. We stand upon the authority of the word of God that no weapon that is formed against us shall prosper. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, multi-system inflammatory syndrome, pack your load and go back to hell where you came from. In the name of Jesus, if it is man-made, go and visit those who made you. In the name of Jesus, go back to your maker. In the name of Jesus, multi-system inflammatory syndrome, children, you shall not prosper in Canada. You shall not prosper in America. You shall not prosper in Africa. You shall not prosper in Australia. You shall not prosper in Middle East. You shall not prosper in Asia. You shall not prosper in Caribbean Pacific Island. In the name of Jesus, you shall not prosper in Europe. In the name of Jesus, we come against you this morning. We come against you this morning. Multi-system inflammatory syndrome, pack your load and go back to the devil. We shall not prosper in South America. You shall not prosper in the entire North America. We come against you. We come against you. We stand against your oppressions. Pack your load and go. We block you. We arrest you. We destroy you. In the name of Jesus, we stand against you by the blood of Jesus Christ. According to the word of God in Revelation chapter 12, verse 11, that we overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our testimony. In the name of Jesus, all ye MISC, we come against you now. In the name of Jesus, all over the world, she prays we not weep over their children. Coronavirus still there. We are not yet recovered. We come against you in the name of Jesus. Even coronavirus, we come against you and your younger brother. We come against both of you together in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Blessed be your name, O God. In Jesus' name we are prayed. Amen. Amen. And amen. If you can open your Bible quickly with me to Psalm 33. Psalm 33. We will read from verse 10. Psalm 33 from verse 10 to 12. The Bible says, the Lord bringeth the counsel of the heathen to naught. He maketh the devices of the people of no effect. The counsel of the Lord standeth forever. The thoughts of his heart to all generations. Blessed is the man, blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord, and the people whom he had chosen for his own inheritance. We are going to be praying this morning quickly from that verse 10. I say, Lord, we pray in the name of Jesus, bring the counsel of the wicked to nothing. Bring the counsel of the wicked against my life, against my family, against my nation. Bring it to nothing in the name of Jesus. Father God Almighty, the counsel of the messengers of Satan. Father, bring it to nothing over our lives. Bring it to nothing over our families. The counsel of the witchcraft, those who practice witchcraft, wizardry, sorceries, and so on and so forth. Father, bring their counsel against us to nothing. Bring their counsel against our nation to nothing. Father, in the name of Jesus. Make their devices of no effect. Make their devices of no effect. Even the Bible says in Job chapter 5 verse 12 that he disappointed the devices of the crafty, and their hands could not perform their enterprise. Their hands could not do their business. Oh God Almighty, in the name of Jesus, bring the devices of the wicked to no effect over my life, over my family, over my children, over my nation, in the name of Jesus. Oh God Almighty, katama shoot ahenda, in the name of Jesus. Father God Almighty, let your concept be established. Oh Lord, let your concept be established concerning me. Let your concept be established concerning our nations. Let your concept be established forever and ever, in the name of Jesus. Father, we call upon you. Come and be our Lord in our nations, oh God. Even the nations where they have legislated that they don't want you, you are the governor among the nations. You created those nations. You can enter without any president. You can enter without any prime minister. Oh Lord, we exalt you up in this land. We exalt you in this land. We lift your name on high in the name of Jesus. Come and be our ruler. Come and be our maker in the name of Jesus. Come and be our ruler. Come and be our defender. Come and be our protector in the name of Jesus. Come and be our protector, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Come and be our defense. Come and be our chief security in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Blessed be the name of the Lord. For we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Father, we just want to say thank you this morning. We bless your name. We magnify you for the prayers that have been offered this morning. Holy Spirit divine, we just want to say we love you. We love you with the everlasting love that you loved us. Father, we just say thank you this morning. And as we continue, Holy Spirit, continue with us. We cover the prayers with the blood of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father, for we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. I welcome you all to church this morning. And I pray in the name of Jesus, the Lord will bless you. The Lord will increase you. The Lord will answer your prayers in the name of Jesus. You may please have your seat. If you are not sitting in your house, you please have your seat. God bless you all in Jesus' name. And quickly, before we go to the Word of God this morning, by the grace of God, next month, the church, the church building will be reopened by the grace of God. The new guidelines for places of worship is now 50. It's now 50 in Abata province, or one third of the building capacity, whichever is less, not whichever is more. Whichever is less. So you will give us a few time for us to be able to plan and arrange how the auditorium is going to look like. It's going to be different from the one we were used to. According to the new guidelines, we are going to observe everything. And if it is to be rotating, the people that are coming to for bodily worship every Sunday, to be rotating it, we don't mind. All what we need to do is to obey the law of the land, to obey the authority of the government, by the grace of God, the guidance. So we are going to be observing it so that the place of worship can be safe enough for every one of us to be able to worship. By the grace of God, I have the copy of the new guidance that was published on the 23rd of this month. God bless you in the name of Jesus. Don't forget, the month is ending today. Tomorrow, we are starting our monthly prayer and fasting. So on the 1st, 2nd, and 3rd, and by the grace of God, we'll be praying every evening. We pray every evening. The details of the prayer, the details will be rolled out to us. We pray every evening at 6:30 p.m. And the month of June shall be our month of prayer. It's our month of prayer. The Bible says the ears of the Lord is open to the prayers of the righteous. So the things that the righteous will do in the month of June is to pray. And the Lord will bless us in Jesus' name. Don't forget, on Wednesday, 3rd of this month, is our Holy Communion service, monthly Holy Communion service at 7 p.m. Monthly Holy Communion service at 7 p.m., which means the prayer that we will not start the evening prayer on Wednesday at 6:30. We will start at 7 p.m. because of the Holy Communion, so that it can be together. We still not stretch the time beyond necessary. The Lord will bless us in Jesus' name. And by the grace of God, by the leading of the Holy Spirit, we are going next month, which is month of June, we are going to start our monthly online prayer service, monthly online program. And the theme, according to the way God gave me, I think I've announced it before we departed in March, the theme is I decree. The theme is I decree. It's not a program to come and preach or to come and make oratory. It's prayer. Basically, those who want to pray. So it's going to be online. And by the grace of God, it's going to be one of the Fridays in the month. Maybe probably the third Friday of every month. The third Friday of every month. And the time is 10 p.m. Mountain Time. 10 p.m. Mountain Time. And the Lord will bless us in the name of Jesus. And I want to encourage us, let's continue praying for our children. I pray you will not lose any child under your roof. In the name of Jesus. Any child associated, connected, related with you and your family, you will not lose anyone to MISC. In the name of Jesus. So quickly this morning, this month has been very fantastic. It has been a month of exceeding grace. And I believe in one way or the other, grace has worked in your life. I have testimonies of what grace has done in my life this month. This month, God has been so gracious to me. I enjoyed and experienced the grace. So I can still preach more and more about grace by the grace of God. Apart from the grace that saved my soul, apart from this grace-saving grace that saved my soul, I enjoy some other benefits because grace is not only to be saved. We have grace for sanctification. We have grace for miraculous. We have grace even for service. Hallelujah. And I pray in the name of Jesus, you will enjoy everything God has proposed for your life. You will serve God diligently. Nothing will happen in your relationship with God. And you will make heaven in the name of Jesus. Grace will lead us home in the name of Jesus. Work will not lead home. Grace leads home. Strength will not lead home. Grace will lead home. I pray in the name of Jesus that will be our portion in the name of Jesus. The audacity of exceeding grace of God, part 5. The audacity of exceeding grace of God, part 5. That's what we are looking at this morning, by the grace of God. And the focus this morning, we will quickly look at the connections between human attitudes and the grace of God. The connections between the human attitudes and the grace of God. Hallelujah. The connection. So we are going to begin to read. We are going to read two Bible passages. 1 Samuel chapter 18, verse 14 to 15. 1 Samuel chapter 18, verse 14 through 15. And Proverbs chapter 23, verse 6 through 7. Proverbs chapter 23, verse 6 through 7. I will read 1 Samuel chapter 18 quickly, verse 14 through 15. And David behaved himself wisely in all his ways, and the Lord was with him. The grace was with him. Wherefore, when Saul saw that he behaved himself very wisely, he was afraid of him. Proverbs 23, verse 6 and 7. If thou know the bread of him that hath an evil eye, neither desire thou his dainty meats. For as he thinketh in his heart, so is he. Eat and drink, said he to thee, but his heart is not with thee. The Lord bless the reading of his word in the mighty name of Jesus. I want us to take note of this Bible passage. It's not actually the part of the anchor scripture, but I want us to take note of it. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16. 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 16. The Bible says, all scripture is given by inspiration of God. You can see, not by inspiration of man. All scripture is given by inspiration of God and is profitable for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. And remember, the Bible says in Titus chapter 2, verse 11 and 12, that the grace that bringeth salvation and appear unto all men, teaching us to deny ungodliness, worldliness, that we should live soberly, soberly. We should live godly and righteously in this present world. So you can see that the way we respond, our attitude towards the grace of God is very, very important to what we get to get. It's important to what we, that God, what God will give unto us by his grace. Hallelujah. So the word of God is profitable for doctrine,
for doctrinal teaching, for reproof, for correction, for instruction in righteousness. I pray in the name of Jesus, we will not receive the grace of God in vain. In the name of Jesus. We will not receive the grace of God in vain. In the name of Jesus. Remember, I've said it, that grace can be shipwrecked. Grace can be misused. Grace can be mismanaged. Grace can be abandoned. Grace can be silenced. Even grace can be abused. But you will not be that person who will abuse the grace of God. Quickly. Next to knowing Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior is having right attitude to maintain sound spiritual attitudes and sound Christian culture in our relationship with God. 2 Peter chapter 1, if you read from verse 5 to verse 8, 2 Peter chapter 1, the Bible talks about unto your faith, what we should have to eat. Hallelujah. Give me a few minutes, please. Hallelujah. The Bible says, according as his divine power. Verse 5. And beside this, giving all diligence. That's from verse 5. 2 Peter chapter 1. And beside this, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, and to virtue knowledge, and to knowledge temperance, and to temperance patience, and to patience godliness, and to godliness brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness charity. For if these things be in you and abound, they make you that you shall never be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. Brethren, that is why faith is not sufficient in itself alone. Virtue means Jesus' character. Virtue is Jesus' character itself. That's why the Bible says, let this mind be in you. When we are talking about this virtue that the Bible says we should have to our faith, is to have the character of Jesus Christ. Is to have the mind of Jesus Christ. When you say you are a Christian, when I say that I am a Christian, my mindset, the way I think, the way I reason, the way I do things, it must be the way Jesus will do it. Whatever I think towards my brethren, or towards a brother, or towards a sister, or towards a friend, towards anybody, that it should be what that thing that Jesus will think towards them. Hallelujah. So, add to your faith virtue. Hallelujah. So the level of grace that God releases into your life will be determined by the quality of your attitudes towards him. The level of grace that you will enjoy, the manifold of grace that God will release into your life, it will be determined by the quality of your attitudes towards God. The quality of your attitudes towards the things of God and the people. All these three things are very important. Look at what the Bible says in James chapter 4 verse 6. The Bible says, but he giveth more grace. But he giveth more grace. And full stop. That is to say, grace is in measure. Grace can be had. God can add to the level of grace in your life. Today, maybe you are in elementary level of grace. Tomorrow, you can be in secondary level or high school level. To next tomorrow, God can increase you depending on how you are managing it. That's why on Wednesday, I preached about grace management. When you know how to manage grace, you will increase. You don't just give your life to Christ and remain a baby Christian. You have to grow. You have to grow. That's why any child that is not growing, you will see the parents will be lamenting. They will be moving from hospital to hospital, from doctors to doctors. That this death helps us to check whether there's something wrong with his hormones, whether it has hormonal problem, whatever. I pray in the name of Jesus, you will grow in grace in the name of Jesus. So, brethren, grace has measures. Look at what the Bible says in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 7. Ephesians chapter 4, verse 7, the Bible says, but unto every one of us is given grace according to the measure of the gift of Christ. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So God can release grace in various dimensions into your life. That is why we must not also confuse talents. Natural abilities is different from grace. Unfortunately, some people normally Christianize natural abilities to mean grace. No, Grace is divine. Natural ability is natural.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
For example, anybody can hold a microphone and speak. If you give a microphone to a doctor can give you, can present the paper, can speak. But not everybody can hold a microphone and minister grace to the life of the people. And minister. There's a difference between ministering and speaking. That is why, especially during this period, you can see during this period, we don't need, that's why you see motivational speakers, even they kept quiet. Because we don't need motivation in this COVID. We need word of life.
Right.
You don't know. You can see there is no conferences for motivation. They close, even they shut down. Only the word of life is thriving all over the world. How many motivational speakers have you seen talking there or even on Facebook, and especially at this time? If there is any, few. But word of life, as I'm talking now, many preachers are there speaking the word of Jesus Christ at the same time. In the name of Jesus, you will grow in grace in the precious name of Jesus. Look at what the Bible says in 2 Peter chapter 3, verse 18. But grow in grace and in the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him be the glory, both now and forever. Amen. Grow in grace. 2 Peter 3, 18. So quickly, because of our time, let us look at when we're talking about the attitude of men. The attitude. Our attitude. Even God. Can I quickly give you this good news this morning? You know, I saw this when I was studying. God's attitude towards us is grace. God's attitude towards us is his loving kindness, the goodwill, and the grace and his favor that he has released upon us. That's God's attitude. Look at what the Bible says. You know, I was ruminating about Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11. He said, "I know the thought that I think towards you. The thought of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end." The attitude of God towards us, the thought of God towards us, is of loving kindness, is of peace, and is of favor. That is what I'm talking about, those who have given their life to Christ. Because anybody who has not given his life to Jesus, the first grace that he needs to receive from God is saving grace. I'm repeating it again. It's saving grace, not all of that dimensions of grace. Hallelujah. So, what is an attitude? An attitude is a manner of thinking, feeling, or behaving that reflects a state of mind or disposition. No, where we just read Proverbs 23, verse 7. For as he thinketh in his heart, so is he. Proverbs 23, verse 7. Eat and drink, say he to thee, but his heart is not with thee. Imagine somebody offered you a box of pizza, so he eat one, and in his mind was imagining, I wish that this guy should eat this pizza and just die now. That's why. Thank God that God is not revealing the thoughts of people around you to you. I think if God is doing that, we will not be able to come out of our house again. Because even if you are trying to cross the road on the zebra crossing or speed zebra crossing, even the driver will look at them. Why are you crossing? We better wait so that I cross your head. Hallelujah. For as he thinketh in his heart, that is why the heart of every matter is the matter of heart. The heart of every matter is a matter of heart. So the state is a manner of thinking, feeling, or behaving that reflects a state of mind. When somebody is acting somehow, check his mind. Something is wrong with his mind. When somebody demonstrates a kind of attitude towards you, it is not the action that really matters. It's the motive. The motive is inside. The motive has something to do with the mind. That's why you don't see the motive. Motive is from the mind. Let's carry on, because I'm looking at the time seriously this morning. That's why the Bible says in Proverbs chapter 4, verse 23. Proverbs chapter 4, verse 23. The Bible says, "Keep the heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life." If your heart is very wrong, your actions will be wrong. You can't have a wrong, you can't have a right, you can't have a wrong heart and have a right action. Action that follows the state of heart is always negative. I mean, when the state of heart is negative, there's no way you can't produce. That's why the Bible says, even out of abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Hallelujah. Quickly, number two. Attitude is a mental state relative to what we believe and that affects our entire lives. Your attitude can affect your entire life. your attitude to God, your attitude to the things of God, your attitude to people can affect your life. Many people have lost favor in life as a result of their attitudes. They have lost good things with men because they don't have the right attitude to get that thing or to maintain it. Attitude is a mental state. So we express our attitude in our words and actions. If somebody loves you, you will see the expression in his words. You will see the expressions in his action. Somebody cannot be professing that, you know, I love you. And the, you know, he's professing, I love you. But the situation of actions, when you look at the action, you know that this guy hates me. Or somebody just walk up to somebody, why do you hate me? I don't hate you. But the way you behave, I can see that you hate me, you don't like me. Hallelujah. Number three. So that's why it is said in the society, action speaks louder than voice. Tell somebody, what's your attitude? So number three, attitude is an inward feeling expressed through outward behavior. Attitude is an inward feeling expressed through outward behavior. Look at this one. 1 Samuel chapter 18 verse 14. Where we read? 1 Samuel chapter 18 verse 14. And David behaved himself wisely in all his ways, not in some of his ways. Not in few of his ways, not in many of his ways, in all his ways. And the Lord was with him. You know, the Lord was with him in that place, I can say, and the grace of God was with him. Hallelujah. When the grace of God is with you, it will enable you, it will help you to behave yourself wisely. Even in the presence of God, even in the presence of the people, you behave yourself wisely. David behaved himself wisely. If you read further, you see that even the king Saul was afraid of him when he saw that David behaved himself wisely. That's why it is dangerous to behave foolishly. That is why one of the most important prayers everyone should be praying, that Lord, give me wisdom to act. Anywhere I need to act, give me wisdom. Give me wisdom. Give me wisdom. In the mighty name of Jesus. Attitude number four. Attitude can be used to express the way someone behaves. You can see. You can see connection. The connection is still there. The way you behave is very, very important. It's very, because your thinking is what shapes your behavior. You don't just act. You act in relation with what is going on in your mind. Hallelujah. Because of how they think or see things. Attitude can be used to express the way someone behaves because of how they think or see things. That is to say, you cannot grow beyond your level of thinking in the school of grace. When you have a quality thought, you have a quality life. When you have a quality thoughts in your heart, you have a quality behavior. When you have a quality thoughts, you have a quality disposition towards things. You have a quality perspective or perception about situations. That's why the way you see things is very important. When somebody is seeing things, you know, when if I ask you now, the picture on your the portrait on your wall, the picture that you hang on your wall, what do you think about it? You have to look at the picture. When you look at the picture, you think. In 1 second, you think before you speak. That's why it is said, think before you speak. You have to think. Is it beautiful? Is it not beautiful? Then you respond. Hallelujah. Look at what Bible says here. In Numbers chapter 13. Numbers chapter 13, verse 32 and 33. And they brought up an evil report of the land, which they had searched unto the children of Israel, saying, the land through which we have gone to search, we have searched it, is a land that eateth up the inhabitants thereof. I don't know who gave them that information. And all the people that we saw in it are men of a great stature. Mm-hmm. And there we saw the giants, the son of Anak, which come of the giants. And we were in our own sight as grasshoppers. And so we were in their sight. When did they have discussion with them? For those people to tell them that, oh, grasshoppers, welcome to our town. You can see. So all this is a matter of attitude. It's attitude of the mind. It is the attitude of the mind. They say in our own sight as grasshopper. We were in our own sight. Not those people called us grasshopper. We assume and we concluded that these guys, they are grasshoppers because we think we don't have abilities. We don't have power to confront that Satan. Hallelujah. That is why many people run away from Satan. Because they don't know the one who is in them. They don't know the word of God. The Bible says, greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. When you are a child of God, when you are a true believer, you fear no foe. Because greater is he that is in you than he that is in a witch. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in a sorcerer. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in a voodoo practitioner. Greater is he that is in you than he that is in the art or in the person who practices abstract projections. You must arm yourself with this truth. That is why it's a state of mind. Attitudes is very important. Tell somebody, your attitude is very important. If you are going to have victories in the battles of life, it's a matter of attitudes. It's not a matter of skills. That is why the attitude of the mind is what is making an elephant to run away from a lion. Do you understand that? Attitude of the mind is what is making an elephant, a giraffe, to run away from a lion. Who is bigger? Between an elephant and a lion. But anytime a lion sees an elephant, he sees whether breakfast or lunch or dinner, as the case may be. And anytime an elephant sees a lion, he sees somebody who's coming to eat dinner or lunch or breakfast. So an elephant sees itself as a food. Why the lion sees an elephant also as a food? Why? Because of the state of the mind. Why? Because of the attitudes. The difference between a lion and an elephant is not the size, it's the attitude of the mind. Amen. Let's quickly look at some salient truths. Anyway, I reach before they reach the time, that's where we are going to stop today. Hallelujah. I have so many things to say. The Lord will help me in Jesus' name. Let's look at some salient truths about the attitudes, our attitudes to the grace of God. Or our attitudes that increases us in the school of grace. Number one, I say this, grace is God's attitude through his thoughts towards us, and is that of goodwill, loving kindness, and favor. That is why the Bible says in John chapter 3, verse 16, for God so loved the world, and he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him will not perish, but we have everlasting life. So God, even if I thought God was mad in the Garden of Eden, but when he was mad with them, remember, he didn't chase them out of the Garden of Eden with, even with the apron they made for themselves from the leaves. Because God asked for the understanding that the leaves will dry off from their body and they become naked and everybody, and life will not progress with them. God still killed animals and give them apron through the skin of the animal. Not only that, God had told them, be fruitful and multiply. Do you know God didn't remove the statement? He still made them to continue to be fruitful and to be multiplied. That is the grace of God. That is why I said, you must not take the grace of God for granted. That's why grace of God is not a license to live anyhow. The grace of God is not a license to live a life of sin. According to the book of Romans chapter 6 verse 1 and 2, can we continue in saying that the grace of God may abide? The Bible says God forbid. Hallelujah. So grace is God's attitude through his thoughts towards us, and is that of goodwill, loving kindness, and favor. And number two, your attitude reveals the real you. Your attitude reveals the real you. It cannot be covered with any makeup or facial painting or anything. It represents your character. That's your attitude. It reveals the real you. When people want to know you, they don't study the way you think, because nobody can see the way you think. They study the output of your thoughts, which is your behaviors, which is your characters, the way you act, the way you respond to situations. They begin to study. Then you hear something like, I'm studying you, I'm watching you. Where you are, I'm watching you. The person is not watching your head. It's not watching your brain or your mind to see what you are thinking. It's not watching what you are thinking out there. It's watching only the outputs of your thoughts. So when you begin to act, and then when you begin to speak, the person will know this. Even from your speeches or from your what you are saying, the person will know the state of your mind. When you begin to put words together, then the person listening, that's why it's good to be a good listener. When you,
And you begin to speak, you see the person looking at you, looking at you. Then you just hear something like, so in summary, this is what you are saying. No, I didn't say that. But this is what you just said. No, I didn't say that. But I just argued loud and clear. You mentioned it, you said it. Then it became an argument. You said, no, I didn't say that, but you said it. Okay, tell me the meaning of the person we just put before you, the underlying statement. Then you keep quiet, begin to watch. But you didn't know why you said that. Hallelujah. So your attitude determines, your attitude reveals the real you. It cannot be covered with any makeup or facial painting. That's why, you know, I love a portion in the Bible that says, even when they fool, when he's quiet, when he keeps his mouth, people think that he's wise. Because you don't know what he's thinking. And you don't even know he's a stupid person. I love that type of passage. I don't know why. That a fool, when he's quiet, people think he's a wise person. That is why there's a time to speak and there's time to be quiet. If you speak when you're supposed not to speak, people will think that you're a fool. Meanwhile, you are better than a fool. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That is why I said something some time ago. Anytime you open your mouth to speak or I open my mouth to speak, I'm on trial. It's like you are in a court of law. Anytime we speak, because somebody, you are not the one that will listen to yourself. If at all you are hearing yourself, but somebody is listening to you, is paying attention. That's why somebody, just listen to yourself. Just listen. Then, what? Just listen to yourself. Hallelujah. Number three, quickly. Your attitude determines your altitude in life. Your attitude determines your altitude in life. No person can go farther beyond his or her attitudinal level. No person can go far. If you give the person another opportunity, an extended opportunity, he will mess up. Hallelujah. In relationship with God or with men, nobody. You can't go farther beyond your attitudinal level. When you see the level of progress in the life of somebody, I'm not talking about somebody being attacked by witches or wizards or, you know, Africa and all those attacks, you know, coming from everywhere. No, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about being in your right frame of mind. Nobody is sending evil arrow against you. Nobody is, is punching you in the midnight or in the dream or whatever now. But this is you now. You, correct person, correct man, or correct woman. Hallelujah. When you don't have the right attitude, there's a limit to level you can reach. There's a level you can reach that even your academic qualifications will not be able to help you. You need only attitude. That is why they said beauty can get you into a marriage, but it takes character to remain in the marriage. Hallelujah. That is why even for those of us in ministry, there's a difference between anointing and character. You can be anointed, but when you don't have the right character, you can't go very far. David was anointed, but he behaved himself wisely before Saul. He behaved himself wisely all his days. He behaved himself wisely. Even the boss was afraid of him. The boss was afraid of him. That this guy, this guy is different. I'm afraid of this guy because I don't even know what he's thinking, the way he's behaving. Hallelujah. If you are going to receive favor from men, you are going to receive favor from God. Your attitude also is very important. You can't cast what is meant for a child or for children. You cast it to the dogs. If I thought the woman said, master, the dogs eat from the crumbs. I'm not created to eat crumbs. I'm created to eat from the table. You must have that understanding. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So King Saul, if you look at King Saul, for example, he was nobody. The father's ass got lost, and they were looking for it. Just imagine the kind of person he was. Even as when they were looking for it, when the servant of the master of the father said, King Saul, there's a seer over there. Let's go to him. That's actually 1 Samuel chapter 10. Let's go to the seer. He's over there. You know the next thing Saul says? God's Saul said, because according to the custom, you don't go to the seer's house empty-handed. But this generation has bastardized that. You don't go to the seer's house empty-handed. If you are going to seer's house, you have to go with something in your hand. If at all the seer is not hungry, hallelujah, you have to give something to the seer. I took that word of God literally. I'm saying it in the air. It's very strange. I don't think so. I pray that will not happen to me. So you don't go to the seer's house empty-handed. He said, what shall we give to the man? You know I'm broke. That's what Saul told the guy. You know I'm broke. What shall we give to the man? The guy said, I will borrow you. I will lend you. I have some money here. Broke man. Boss child. Broke. And they went. The guy lent him the money. And And that the day, he gave something to Samuel. And he got the anointing upon his head and all those things. But he messed up. You know why he messed up? He got anointed as the first king of Israel on a platter of gold. There was no kingmakers. You know, there was no selections. They didn't bring five people to compete with him. He was the only one. He got anointed cheaply. But he messed up. That's why I said sometimes people don't value what they get for free. People don't value it. He got it for free. And he lost it. Hallelujah. Time will not permit me to be able to read. I was analyzing it, how he lost it when I was preparing. If you read 1 Samuel chapter 15, verse 17, verse 21 to 23, then you read verse 24 and 26, you will see how Saul messed up. Because in 1 Samuel chapter 10, the Spirit of God came upon him. He prophesied. The Spirit visited him. He was not a prophet. The Spirit, now listen to this. That's why many people bastardize prophetic ministry. The Spirit of God can come upon you to operate that office for the moment. But you are not called. There are people who are permanently called into that office. They are prophets. God made them, what they receive from God is prophet. But if the spirit of prophecy comes on you and you operate in the office of prophecy and you showed up the following day looking for an office to rent, Prophetic Ministration International Incorporated, Ministry Incorporation, because you prophesied yesterday, you think today you are a prophet, you are deceiving yourself. Because you are not called to that office, the spirit of prophecy came upon you. You can prophesy. That was what came upon Saul. And he took what God said he should destroy. He took them. He said the people took them. Fine. Prophet Samuel didn't come on time. He said, oh, those things you brought from the land of Amalekites, come and sacrifice. He offered sacrifice. And the moment the sacrifice goes up, the prophet of God showed up. Hallelujah. And that was the end of the kingdom. Like that day, he got a prophecy from the mouth of the man of God. The prophet Eli. The prophet Samuel told him, the kingdom has been taken away from you and has been given to a neighbor that is better than you. The neighbor that has a better attitude. David was the man who had a better attitude. How on earth will you think that it, among all the servants of Saul, among all the people, you know, David was a captain. Among all the people working with Saul, it was David who was going to succeed him. How will you think about that? How will you just... But the Bible says he behaved himself wisely, and the Lord was with him. I pray for somebody. God will not depart from you in the name of Jesus. It doesn't matter who departs from your life. When God does not depart from you, you are one man battalion. It doesn't matter. Those who left, they will come. But if the level you will get to, they will come. Those who left, they will come. Because they have seen that the Lord is with thee. I pray for somebody this morning. God will not depart from you in the name of Jesus. That is why don't do the things that will make God to depart from you. Don't do the things that will make the presence of Jesus Christ to neglect you. I pray in the name of Jesus, you will maintain the right attitude and God will abide with you still in the name of Jesus. That is why you see the life of Joseph. And the Bible says, and the Lord was with Joseph. And the Lord was with Joseph. And the Lord was with Joseph. You know what? Joseph was a man with the right attitude. Even when he had opportunity to imprison those who sold him into slavery, he didn't still sell them. He didn't still jail them. He gave them lands. He gave them food. He empowered them financially and in business. That was the response to the thing he should have done. Hallelujah. I pray in the name of Jesus, God will give me the right attitude. God will give you the right attitude in the name of Jesus. When people are running away from you, you are not smelling, but watch your attitude. When people don't want to relate with you, when they avoid you, watch out. Don't look at what. Don't begin to cast out the devil of rejection. First look at the devil of stubbornness. First look at the devil. Look inward. That's how I always look. That's my style. When I see that something is not correct, that is happening, I look inward first before I begin to pray so that I will not use prayer to kill myself. Hallelujah. You look inward, then before you look outward, then you look around. Those are the progressions. But people tend to look outward first. Only those fire, every enemy of rejection. You are the rejection. You are the one causing it. Change your attitude. Favor flows into your life ceaselessly.
Goodness flows into your life ceaselessly. Mercy flows into your life ceaselessly. Favor of God, favor with man flows into your life ceaselessly. Have a right attitude. Be dependable. Be trustworthy. Maintain loyalty when you are at the place of work. I'm telling you, things that people are struggling to get, it be coming to your table by itself. I've come, possess me. And I love that kind of lifestyle. People are struggling to get it. When you have the right attitude and you have the right standing with God, you don't abuse the grace of God, you don't receive the grace of God in vain. You know that the grace saved your life, and you maintain on the narrow way. You stand in that narrow way, not one leg in and one leg out. You are not walking like this. And Satan comes to break the leg at the end of the day. Then you crush out, or you are crushed out. No, you maintain the right standing with God. You follow righteousness. You follow holiness. You follow the way of goodness. You follow the way of mercy. I'm telling you, things that people are struggling for out there will come to your table. Possess me. I am here. Amen. Number five, I think I'm going to stop there today. Oh, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Look at what the Bible says here. Your attitudes, number four, okay. Your attitudes always become actions or reactions. Your attitude becomes action or reactions. Matthew chapter 15, verse 17 to 20. Matthew chapter 15, verse 17 to 20. The Bible says, do not ye yet understand that whatsoever entereth in at the mouth, goes into the belly, and is cast out into the trunk. But those things which proceeded out of the mouth come forth from the heart, not from the stomach now. Those that proceeded out of the mouth, come from the heart, and they defy the man. So your mouth can defy you. When you speak vain things, when you make vulgar statements, when you say rubbish, it can defy you. It can make you dirty. Whether before God and before men. Hallelujah. I remember some when I was growing up in the church that I used to have somebody around me then when I was in school. Everything coming out from his mouth is always deadly. And one of the things I was doing stylishly is to avoid, not to work with him. I try as much as possible because there is nothing pleasant that will ever come out of that guy's mouth. I don't know what is wrong with his state of mind. Anything is to anybody, not to me alone. Anybody is always negative. And when I discover that, don't put me in trouble. Hallelujah. That is why it is possible for somebody's mouth to put him in trouble. If you want to know, it's in the scripture. The man that didn't kill King Saul, he didn't know who killed King Saul. He just came. Oh, King David, I have killed, I'm here. I met your enemy and I fell on him. David said, you did what? I killed King Saul. You killed King Saul. Okay, David rent his cloak. Oh, you killed King Saul. You are not afraid to touch the anointed. And King David commanded. I forgot the name of that guy now. Commanded one of these mighty men. Please follow him. Make sure that his head does not rest in his head. His head does not rest on his neck. Right today, the man was killed. They killed him. You know what? He didn't kill King Saul. Even he didn't even see King Saul when he was killed. He just saw all he had, that King Saul had been killed, or he's dead. He wanted favor. He used his mouth to defy his life, and he paid for it with his life. He said, David commanded, kill him now. And he was killed. Hallelujah. For out of the heart proceeded evil thoughts. Out of the heart. What is the state of your heart? Murders. Somebody will not just kill. The person had killed before committing the murder. He has killed since. Somebody might be watching, you're going out, coming every day, they say, one day I'm going to kill this guy. The day he shoots at you, it's not the day you're dead. He has killed you since 2015. He's just waiting for appointed time to shoot the gun. Hallelujah. Adulteries, fornications, all these things, they are the things of the mind. That's why the Bible says, keep your heart with all diligence. Thefts. I'm going to steal that thing from him one day. I'm going to steal that thing. It's not the day he steals it that he has done it. False witness, blasphemies, they are the things of the heart. Hallelujah. I pray in the name of Jesus. The Bible says, these are the things which defile a man. But to eat with unwashing hands defileth not a man. You only have cholera at the end of the day. If you didn't wash your hands, and especially this time that you have touched services out there, and then
You don't know who has passed where. Just get to there. You are, you know, popsy pizza, right? You brought out your pizza. I'm telling you, Abata High Services might likely have you as one of the numbers. So that will never be your portion. That's why we are trying to put everything in place for the church so that we can have a hand wash station, all those things, so that we arrange very well before people begin to come in to the church. Hallelujah. And finally, this one, I'm going to stop here because of the time. Your attitude determines the level of grace and favor that come into your life. Your attitude has capacity to determine the level of grace and favor that come into your life. When you are struggling unnecessarily, when you see that there are things there are areas of your life where you can be graced. You know, there's people they are graced to be a giver, not giving by natural ability. There are people they are graced to serve. They love service. When they see anything that comes in, anything that is of service, towards humanity, towards God, it makes them to be restless. Not just having strength to do something now. Are you with me? But when the attitude to the grace, what you had, your attitude to God, to the things of God and to men, is correct. I'm telling you, the level of grace in your life will increase. God, Bible says, God giveth grace, giveth more grace, right? He giveth more grace. So God, more grace can be given to you. Why are you still sitting down there in this elementary grace level? Where you can go out there and evangelize. When you can go out there and preach the kingdom and preach the message of the kingdom of God. When you can go out there, the more you go, the more power you experience. The Bible says, as they went, God was confirming the power with them. As they went. That's why God wants us to go. He wants us to go out there to preach. He wants us to go out there to represent Him. We are the ambassadors of Christ. You are not ambassador for fun. You are not ambassador to sit down and be watching people doing things. Be among the people that make things happen in the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. I pray in the name of Jesus. Receive that grace in the name of Jesus. Receive grace to preach the gospel. You might not likely be called to be an evangelist. You don't need to be called an evangelist, but you have grace to speak to people. You have grace to preach the gospel. You can preach the word of God. You can do all some other things even in your local church. Stop watching things happening. Be among the people making things happening. I hate seeing things happening, and I don't know how it's happening. I don't like it. By the grace of God, there is no church has ever stepped into in my life since I gave my life to Jesus, and I have been watching them doing things. I remember one day I got to a particular church. Even the drum set, the seat on the drum set was not good because there was nobody to play drum set for them, and I could play it. As I sat on the thing fell, I scattered. And they gathered the seat under me because I have to continue. I was laughing at them, but I was enjoying it. And so many other things. Jesus said, our Lord and Savior said, my Father walketh hitherto, I walk. And he said something. In John chapter 9, verse 4, which is my favorite Bible passage. I must walk the work of him that sent me. When it is day, the night comes, when no man can walk again. It's a statement of grace. It's a statement of attitude, rather. Attitude towards the things of God. That's why I said, never be presumed, never be assumed to be the kind of person that have a negative attitude to assignment at your workplace. If you are a true child of God. If you are a true child of God, never dodge a task, especially a task that promotes your organization that you have signed contract with, and they are paying you salary, and you begin to dodge the things that promote them. You are unfaithful. God might punish you for that. So attitude is very important. That I'm saying this so that we not think that it's only in the church we need to have right attitude. No, at your workplace, it's important. It's important. It's very, very important because they are studying you. If they promote a guy who just came and very hardworking, so that you don't complain, Pastor, please pray for me, I'm not being promoted. What is the state of your attitude? What is the condition of your heart at your workplace? Are you among the guys dodging assignments and promotion is eluding you? You can when you dodge assignments, promotion can elude you. They can promote somebody, people who are hardworking out to the task. But God, they will think that you don't have the ability, then they leave you in that level. Then you say, Pastor, please pray. Join me in prayer. Agree with me so that I can be promoted. God will say, I won't hear. You know why? The prayer of the Lord, the prayer of the righteous, the ears of the Lord are open unto the prayer of the righteous, not the prayer of unrighteous. Lift up your hands. You lift up your hands and just give God the glory for the word you have had this morning. Bless his holy name, magnify him. I believe in one way or the other, God has spoken to you. You have been blessed. Give him glory, magnify his holy name, exalt him. Give him praise. Say, Lord, I worship you, Lord. I give you glory. Help me in the journey of my life. Lord, help me not to receive your grace in vain. Help me not to mismanage your grace. Help me not to abuse your grace. Help me not to abandon your grace. Help me not to misshipwreck your grace. Help me not to corrupt myself so that your grace departs from me. Father God Almighty, let me not silence your grace. Oh God, help me not reject your grace. Oh God Almighty, please help me. Help me. Help me, oh Lord God Almighty. All the blessings I've received this morning, let it be permanent in my life. Let it be permanent in my family. Let it be permanent in my destiny. In the name of Jesus. Holy Ghost, help me. Pray to God that, Lord, as I go into the month of June, let favor be my portion. Give me the grace to serve you better. All the graces that I've received in the month of May, oh Lord, let me be able to use it to advance your kingdom, to advance your kingdom, to advance my place of work, to advance my family, to advance my destiny in the month of May, in the month of June, in the name of Jesus. As I call on you in the month of June, Lord, answer me by fire. In the name of Jesus, answer me by fire. In the name of Jesus, answer me by fire. In the name of Jesus, thank you, glorious Father. Thank you, everlasting Lord. In Jesus' name, we are praying. Amen. Father, we want to thank you for your word this morning. May your name be highly exalted in Jesus' name. I pray in the name of Jesus, Lord, that the word we have had this morning will prosper in our lives. The word we have had this morning will prosper, will germinate, will fruitful in our lives. In the name of Jesus, I pray in the name of Jesus in the remaining months in this year, grace will answer for you. Grace will work in your life. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, everlasting Father. I pray for those who have given their tithes and their offerings this morning. Father, please bless them in return in the name of Jesus. Lord God Almighty, everyone supporting the furtherance of your work in this place, oh God. Father, support the agenda of their lives in your will in the name of Jesus. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus. I decree and I declare and I prophesy. You will not know the down of life financially in the name of Jesus. Your sources of income, will not be cut off, will not be cut short in the name of Jesus. God will always meet your needs. God will provide for your family. You will not buy for bread. You will not buy for water to drink. In the name of Jesus. The Lord shall bless your bread and he shall bless your water. And he will take diseases far away from you. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, glorious Father. Blessed be your name, O God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Brethren, the Lord bless you. Thank you for joining the service this morning. And I pray in the name of Jesus in the month that we are entering, you will see the wonders of God in the manifold proportions in the name of Jesus. The Lord bless you. Surely, goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Amen. This is my year of new glory, no more defeat and shame, and walking in victory. I will possess my possessions, and I shall be established. Congratulations to me. Congratulations to you all. Don't forget, please, all the announcements, the prayer for children. Let's continue to pray for the children. And by the grace of God, on our Facebook platform that we are using for this service, you will continue to see the reminders for various programs and the information necessary. The Lord bless you in Jesus' name. And I think under the comments, you can see the giving. If you want to give, you can see the details of how to give on PayPal, through the email e-transfer. And the Lord will bless you. Or if you want to post it, if you want to post a check, you will see the details there. God bless you all in the name of Jesus. Thank you for fellowship with RCCG, Peculiar People Assembly, Strathmore today. Have a glorious week ahead of you.